Around the hospital as Bron and Charlotte face the fallout from their night together in All Saints in half an hour here on BBC One.
Good morning, Eric. Let's see what we have here. Oh dear. Not necessarily what I would choose for breakfast. Ah.
Muesli?
No, thanks.
What an omelette. I can do your bacon and egg if you like.
Oh.
Right, just coffee then. You were a bit worse for wear yesterday.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. Had a bit too much to drink. Drowning my sorrows.
And did it help?
Delicious. But we'll have to get some new supplies in, I suppose.
It's only me, Annie.
Ah, morning.
Morning. Just bringing your gravy powder back, thanks for the loan.
No problem. Old comrades should always share. Bung a wee bit of seed in his tray, would you know?
Oh, yes, of course.
Thank you.
He's looking very perky this morning.
Aye. Of course you'd not have to borrow at all, would you, if you only moved in with me?
Hey, give over. Anyway, do you think I'd ever move into the same house as that chair?
What's wrong with it?
What's right with it?
Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Lucky for you.
Hey, watch it. To be honest, Liam, it was a bit scary finding you like that.
What, you mean because of Dad?
I don't want one of you kids ending up with an addiction problem.
I'm sorry I frightened you, Mum. It was a one-off, honestly. I still feel so low. I can't stop thinking about it.
I understand. I do, honestly, sweetheart. It's hard, I know it is. But you do have to try and move on. Just can't let yourself get sucked up in all of this. That's why I think it would be a really good idea if you went out with Melody tonight.
You still coming to the supermarket? Have you written a list?
I didn't have to. I need everything.
Oh, okay then. Well, I'll see you in a minute. I'll just lift back from my trolley. Oh, Ernie!
What? Oh. Ah, right. Thank you.
Been ordering stuff from the catalogue again?
Oh, just a few wee bits and pieces for Eric, you know.
And for the instalments cost you this time.
That woman, she'd moiter her life at you. Still, I suppose she's right in her own way, really. I am a bit of a fool, I know that. What I should be doing, of course, is getting myself a new pair of shoes. I've wasted all my money on daft toys for that daft wee budget. What the?
Melody's fun to be with. She's young, she's light-hearted. She'll do you good. I don't don't mean anything serious. I'm not suggesting that for a minute. It's just a good chance for you to get out. Meet some new people. And it beats drinking at home alone.
Okay, I'll go.
You never know, you might even enjoy yourself.
See you later, love.
London.
Ernie, are you ready?
I'm coming. Okay.
Sorry I'm late.
It's okay, Julia's not in yet.
Oh, great.
Oh, aren't you?
Yeah.
Julia asked if you'd spend some time today, given all the phones in the place are really good clean.
Phones?
Yeah, it was in all the papers, wasn't it? How the phones and the TV consoles in hospitals were never cleaned.
They identified it as a missed source of infection.
Oh, yeah, I think I remember reading about it.
Well, there's been some directive from St. Phil's and it's finally got to us. They're sending an inspector around last thing today and Julie wants to make sure all the phones are really clean.
Okay, but why me? Why didn't the cleaners do it?
Yeah, I'm sure I just got better things to do.
Jimmy, what day is it today?
It is Friday, which means we've got till Monday morning.
And you've got the lightest list, I'm afraid, Archie.
Okay, where's the stuff?
Unlucky, mate. Go on, I'll show you.
Oh, you won't believe what we've just done.
Hey, look what? At this. That's four meals you got there for £2. Did you hear what I said?
Great.
Tony. Oh. Thank you. Still 30p. They'll do with a nice cuppa. Are you getting some for yourself, then?
No. I'm going to get these.
Belgian chocolate? What are you doing? You can't afford those. Ernie? Fillet steak? Mozzie roller? Luxury cheesecake? Have you gone mad?
I'm paying for it all, aren't I? Yours too?
But how? You can't possibly afford it. I know exactly how much you get in your pension every week, and it doesn't run to Duck Hull Orange. Where did you get that kind of money from?
I've been putting a wee bit away. Thank you.
I haven't put any of that stuff in my trolley, you know. For all I know, you're up to no good.
Brenda?
No. Until you tell me exactly where that money came from, I'm not touching any of it. What's the matter now?
Nothing.
But it wasn't your fault. When somebody's that unstable...
She shouldn't have left her on her own.
OK, look, this has got to stop. We've had a knot like this. The best thing to do is just get back on the horse. What happened yesterday was exceptional. Being able to pull yourself together after something like that, well, that's a big part of the job.
Yeah.
So, come on. How did this morning go?
Yeah, OK, I think.
That's good.
But I'm supposed to be going on a date with Liam Maguire tonight.
Great, I think that's exactly what you need.
No, I can't. It's too much. I look awful, I feel awful, and I haven't got the energy.
No, rubbish. You scrub it well. I think this date will be the perfect distraction for you.
Do you think so?
Yeah. Look, how about I stay behind tonight and give you some help getting ready?
Thanks, Michelle.
Where's the phone?
So, come on then, Ernie, what's the emergency? You're not still doing your union rep work, are you?
I know, no. My days at the foundry are long gone. It's just that, well, I remember your good advice and all those hard-working men that we tried to help, you know. You see, I've never used a solicitor apart from that, not even when my wife died. So...
What can I do for you?
Well... got this in the post this morning.
How much is there?
Well, all The notes are new and they're bundled, so they were easy to count. 50,000 quid. No, this is no kind of payoff, you know.
Well, it's got to be some kind of link. What have you done that's worth £50,000?
Nothing. It doesn't make any sense.
An old favour?
Look, Mr. Woodson, what I want to know is, what is the legal position on this?
Well, I don't really know, to be honest. This isn't exactly the kind of thing that happens every day. It's been addressed to you specifically. It's a gift. There's nothing to stop anyone sending anything to anyone else.
So it's legit?
I'm going to the police station later on to see a client. I could have the serial numbers checked if you want, put your mind at rest.
Thank you. I have written them down.
Okay. They can't be stolen. They'd be too easy to trace. So I guess that it's all above board. I'd say you've got a very big fan. So what are you going to spend it on?
I don't know. It's all so strange. When I think of the blood, sweat and tears it would have cost me to earn that kind of money, getting this much in one go, scares me.
I'm sure you'll get used to it.
What is it? Some sort of obsession?
He's just acting on a little message you passed on from Julia.
Yeah, it's our way of welcoming Archie into the Mill Health Centre family.
What, like an initiation? How come I didn't get one?
Well, I kind of thought that being taken hostage in your first week was enough.
Oh, look at his little face.
Oh, it's good to see you looking cheerful, Melody. It'd be tough for anybody to bounce back from the kind of day you had yesterday. Anyway, Liam's looking forward to seeing you tonight.
Good.
Please leave your message after the tone.
Ernie, it's Ronnie Woodson here. That money isn't stolen. Looks like it's clean. So I'm going to have a dig around, see if I can find a precedent for this sort of thing. And then I shall call you back. OK? All right, bye.
Money, money, money.
In 1955, I could have bought a house for what you're asking for this lot.
If I had a little money, it's a rich man's world. It's a rich man's world.
Gorgeous.
Thanks.
Liam's a good-looking guy and the boss's son, so you've got to raise your game.
Yeah, you're right. I was really looking forward to this before yesterday.
I don't want my phone cleaned. Why would I want my phone cleaned? You know, this is not professional. Archie, you are a highly trained nurse. And from now on, I want to see you make better use of your time.
I don't get it. There's nothing wrong.
Archie, I'm so sorry. We didn't mean to get into trouble. It was just supposed to be some fun.
You mean you tricked me?
Yeah, well, it was meant to be a joke.
It was some joke? Did you hear her? She thinks I'm a right idiot now, thanks to you. She's going to take me seriously again.
Well, look, it's just a misunderstanding. Yeah, it's all our fault, so I'll go in and I'll see Julia and I'll tell her
that you're the idiot?
Yeah, that I'm the idiot.
And that you and your flaky sidekick are going to go and clean up all the cleaning fluid that I've just spilled on the carpet?
Of course, yeah. Yeah, actually, of course.
And that you're both going to buy me and Julia a really large drink.
Hey! Ha! Archie!
Yeah, well, I knew I was just playing along.
Oh, whatever.
Yeah, right. Oh, honest.
Melody, hadn't you better get a move on? You're going to be late.
You didn't.
What do you mean you don't like it? A budgie with taste already.
You've never been spending again. Why I'm worried about you, Ernie. You're not in the thrall of any loan shark, are you? Well, it can get on your nerves sometimes, I know, watching the pennies. But you know...
This is what came in the post this morning. With a note saying, enjoy.
But who's it from?
I have no idea.
Oh, Ernie. Somebody obviously likes you. Oh, it's fantastic. Just think what you could do with it all. Well, you can get rid of that old thing for a start. And that table, I'm glad to say, but it's looked terrible for years. Get some nice, cheerful paper up. And get rid of those chipped cups and saucers.
They were a wedding present for Margaret and me.
Well, it's time to move on. And you could do with a carpet on the floor, you know.
Oh, yeah, would you move in with me then, eh?
What?
If I got all this new stuff you've been yammering on about, would you then deign to move in with me?
That was a joke. Your joke, and you know it.
Ah, but I'm a different kind of man now, aren't I? I could take you out and buy you things.
You couldn't buy me with all the tea and china, Ernie Spencer.
You sure?
Only you would think that getting a gift like that was a bad thing.
Hello?
Master Woodson.
I have just about had enough. I want you to come over here and take this lot away.
Ernie, did you get my message?
I do not like what money does to people.
I've done some research and...
I've never rowed with Brenda
in 27 years!
I'm going right out now and taking this lot and putting it straight onto a skip.
Ernie, hang on. Promise me you won't do anything until I get there.
All right.
Okay.
All right.
Hi. Oh. Sorry. Sorry, I'm a bit late.
It's fine. Would you like a drink?
Yes, please.
Excuse me, can I ask? How's Ernie enjoying the money?
You gave it to him.
Honey, I haven't seen him spend much of it yet.
Well, have you been watching the house?
I've been following him all day.
Was this some psychological experiment?
No. No, I'm trying to help Ernie. Do you mind if we move away from the house a little? I don't want him to spot me. I'd like to explain.
Thank you.
Thanks.
So, what's it like being in Netherbridge again? Going with your mum?
It's a temporary arrangement. How are you enjoying being a proper doctor? Getting your hands dirty at last?
it was going well, I think. Until yesterday.
I grew up on this street. My dad died when I was 11. And Ernie was really good to me. Taking me to the football, taking an interest in me. Ernie and his wife made sure my mum was okay. Sorted out her money and life insurance for her. Helped to get a job. They were like that.
I can believe it.
I really looked up to him. He always seemed to know what was right.
He's a man of strong principle.
And when we were 16, we moved away to be closer to family. I lost touch with him. Never saw him again. And things picked up for us. I went to university, got a good job.
What do you do?
I'm a merchant banker.
So, what's going on?
If you give someone a present, you want to know if they liked it, don't you? I wanted to see him enjoying the money, buying things he thought he could never have. He doesn't seem to have bought much of anything yet.
Well, actually, Ernie's been been upset by the money.
Upset?
Yeah, it's disturbed him. It's unsettled him.
How do you mean?
I think if you want him to spend any of it, you're going to have to tell him the truth.
But that's not how I wanted to do it.
Well, yeah. Maybe it shouldn't be about what you want.
In here.
We've never argued. Not really. Listen. We can't let money ruin our friendship. It's worth more than that.
You're right. I've had a good think about it, and the conclusion I've come to is that I have got everything I want. See, all these old things around me, these shabby things, they're old friends of mine. And to be honest, I don't know what I'd be able to spend all this money on anyway. See, I'm a happy man. I don't need a car. I've got a bus pass. And I was never given to fancy clothes or rich food.
There must be something that you'd like to buy. Everybody does the lottery once a week.
I don't agree with that.
Maybe you're happy with your familiar stuff around you. But what about a nice holiday, eh? Spain or Tenerife, Portugal, Australia. You could even take me if you like.
You see, who would you be friends with then? Me or my money? I don't know who did this to me, but I am absolutely fed up to the teeth with it. Believe me.
No!
So what do you think? I mean, should I have done it differently? Should I have made her come to the front door with me? Because that might have scared her anyway.
You can only do what you can do.
Yes. Yeah, you're right. Do you fancy some food?
No. Oh, I've got to go.
Oh. You've still got a whole pint of...
Don't you recognise me, Annie?
It's Bill. Billy Simkin.
Billy! Well, I
sent you the money.
You?
I did what you said. I worked hard, got a good job. I'm a rich man. Very rich.
I see.
I wanted to make your life better.
There's nothing wrong with my life. I like things the way they are.
Ernie, I know how low the state pension is, and...
You know nothing. What gives you the right to think of me as the deserving poor, eh? I will not have my strings pulled by some jumped-up city slicker. What did you do? Light the blue touch paper and stand well back and hang around to see the sorry spending spree that you orchestrated?
Ernie...
See this? I have been saving up to buy a new bird cage. Going without for weeks. What was the point of it all?
You're being ungrateful now.
No, I am not. I'm being my own man. There's more to life than what money will bring you.
Ernie, you're right. Of course you are. Billy was just trying to make you a bit more comfortable. Can't you accept this as... I don't know. A redistribution of wealth. Billy's got too much. This is what you've been fighting for, isn't it? This is one of your principles.
It wasn't charity. It was a gift, a thank you.
Billy, if you had wanted to do anything for me, because you've just come around to see me, what we did for you, it was just common decency. I don't want a reward. I'm damn sure Margaret never would have wanted one either.
It's just a present, Ernie. Will you keep it? Please.
You can give some of it away if it makes you feel any better.
And I promise that I won't move in here with you, if it helps.
Thank you. I don't think you went around it the right way, mind. But I do accept that what you did was with the very best of intentions.
Thanks for listening.
That's okay.
I didn't mean to offload on you like that. Just once I get started. You've been really sweet.
I'm sorry, but... Well, this whole thing was a mistake. A bad idea. We shouldn't... I'm sorry, Nathan.
You're home early?
Yep.
So how did it go?
It wasn't that great, actually.
Oh, why? Didn't you like Melody?
I'm sure she's a very nice girl.
She can be a bit silly sometimes.
I'm just not ready to start playing the field yet.
No, it's just Melody just isn't your type, that's all. You leave it with me.
Mum, I know you mean well, but...
There's someone here to see you.
Ocean!
Hello, sweetie.
Ocean! Why don't I come with you?
Well, another time, eh? I've got the whole morning mapped out.
And I'd be in the way, and my opinion counts for nothing.
Well, I wasn't expecting balloons and a banner, but a warm smile would be nice.
You haven't met Nurse Hallam, have you?
I haven't come all this way to hurt you.
Then why are you here?
Just when I thought that I was getting somewhere with Liam, you know, helping me get his life back on track, that woman from Canada shows up.
Tonight at 7.30 on BBC1, there's a chance to see the moving service of Thanksgiving for Diana, shown earlier today. Coming next, All Saints.